The Sky News presenter who asked Tánaiste Simon Coveney if the kerfuffle made by the government over last week's Brexit talks was worth it has responded to criticism of his question. A deal reached by European Union and British negotiating teams on Friday set out guarantees on not having a hard border in Ireland. A previous agreement had been reached on Monday, guaranteeing regulatory alignment between the Republic of Ireland and Northern Ireland. This deal broke down following opposition from the DUP. In the wake of the new agreement being announced, Adam Ballaton asked, Mr. Coveney, do you think this week's kerfuffle has been necessary? I mean, do you feel slightly guilty that perhaps the Irish government overbriefed what had been achieved as a victory over the British for the European Union? That provoked the DUP, and if you had been a bit more straightforward about a practical agreement at the beginning, we wouldn't have had these 4 days of turmoil. The clip received strong criticism on social media, with many criticizing Ballaton's question as being arrogant and condescending in tone. Ballaton defended his interview style in a tweet on Saturday night. Irish Foreign Minister Simon Coveney answers Adam Bolton's Do you think this week's kerfuffle has been necessary? pic.twitter.com KJOVGZ9Y Robert at Rob Dunsmore December 8, 2017 Board now. Some of you Irish need to get over yourselves. Interviewing is about challenging the interviewee not respecting Adam Bolton at Adam Bolton'ski December 9, 2017 Board now. Some of you Irish need to get over yourselves. Interviewing is about challenging the interviewee not respecting, he tweeted. In response to Ballaton's question on Friday, Mr. Coveney denied claiming victory over the British government. Well, clearly that's a briefing you've been getting from the British side. We never looked for or claimed any victory over anybody, he said. We have been saying for many months now that we want to work with the British government to try and find a way forward that can reassure people in Ireland as well as within the UK that we can manage Brexit and we can limit damage in the way that is now in this agreement. That's always been our position. Mr. Coveney acknowledged there had been some friction, as many people have been saying, look, we don't need and don't want to give those assurances right now, we'll deal with these issues in phase two. The Irish government's response to that has always been, that, for us, is like a jump into the dark. He said, we don't know where we're going to land, we don't know whether we're going to have unintended consequences, and we need basic reassurance that actually certain things will not happen under any circumstances when we move on to phase two, and one of those issues is the assurance that there will not be a hard border on the island. Another is that we will protect the Good Friday Agreement, another today is that we will protect peace funding. Another is that we will protect what's called the common travel area between Ireland and Britain so that people can move between both countries and live, and work, and study and access social welfare entitlements, and healthcare and so on. Mr. Coveney said those aspects of the New Deal were really important, they are part of normal life and the relationship between our two islands, which is a complex one but a deeply interwoven one between Irish and British people. We wanted some guarantees and assurances in phase one before we move on to phase two, so that we could settle some of the concerns that people have, and I think we have achieved that by working with the British negotiating team, and others, to make that happen, he said.